Most schools in the Philippines shifting to online classes for at least today and tomorrow due to the extreme heat and the ongoing nationwide transport strike. Weather Bureau Pag-asa says 36 areas in the country will experience dangerous heat levels today. Let's get details from our resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. The country continues to grapple with extreme heat. This weekend, record-breaking heat saw Camiling Tarlac-Sizal to 40.3 degrees Celsius, the hottest this year yet, and Pasay City reaching 38.8 degrees Celsius, the hottest in Metro Manila on record last Saturday. On Sunday, Iba Zambales experienced 53 degrees Celsius heat index, which is the feels-like temperature under the shade. This is the highest heat index this year so far. Nights are also becoming warmer, with Pasay City experiencing the hottest evening from April 27 through April 28, with the lowest temperature at 30.1 degrees Celsius. This Monday, Pag-asa forecasts dangerous levels of heat index of 42 degrees Celsius or higher in 36 areas in the country. The highest will be 47 degrees in Dagupan City, while Metro Manila may experience 42 and 43 degrees Celsius feels-like temperatures in Quezon City and Pasay City. Some areas may experience relief from the sweltering heat as the Intertropical Convergence Zone, or ITZZ, will bring scattered rains in Caraga and Davao region and later in Sokcergen. Afternoon thunderstorms are also expected in Ilocos region, Cordillera, Zambales, Palawan, Negros, and Samar. The intense heat is not seen to let up as the country enters the peak of the warm and dry season through the month of May. Pag-asa forecasts northern and lowlands Luzon gripping with 40 to 41 degree temperatures this May and June. Metro Manila and lowlands Mindanao may continue to experience 38 degrees heat this month of May. Experts, or to prevent heat stress, experts continue to remind the public to avoid direct sun exposure, wearing of comfortable clothing, avoiding heavy physical activities during hot weather, and hydrating frequently. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
All right, Ariel, tell us something about what can we expect in the month of May. Southeast Asia really taking a beating on this very wicked weather. You have Bangkok, for example, the highest temperature from today until Wednesday, 39, but it feels like 45. Are we in for the same conditions, Ariel?
Yes, especially the lowlands part, the central plains of Luzon and northern Luzon. Pag-asa says they may see continuously 40 to 41 degrees Celsius for the month of May. Usually for the warm and dry season of the Philippines, the peak happens during the first 2 weeks of May, and then the latter part, we see more frequent thunderstorms. But that may not be the case for this year, because even with the waning El Nino, the developing La Nina may also prolong the hotter and drier part of this warm and dry season. Pag-asa also says that the rains from the rainy season may not be in until the month of May, of August rather.
Right, and when that sets in, the rainy season come August, what are we expecting then?
Yeah, so there will be a delay in the onset of the rainy season, and after the onset, there will still be less than normal rainfalls. The above normal rains that will be brought by La Nina may not be here until the last quarter of 2024, which will be the months of October, November, and December. So apart from the very hot weather, we will continue to see declining water levels in the Angat Dam.
All right, we're going to have to leave it at that as we continue to monitor this situation. Ariel Rojas, they're a resident meteorologist, joining us this noon. Thanks again. The nation's also sweltering, as you were talking about with Ariel. They're under sweltering heat. In Thailand, the weather agency has warned temperatures could exceed 40 degrees Celsius this week as locals endured searing heat and humidity. At least 30 people have died of heat stroke in Thailand this year. In neighboring Cambodia, temperatures are forecast to hit 43 degrees Celsius, while in Vietnam, the mercury is expected to hit as high as 41 degrees. In Bangladesh, millions of students returned to schools amid the extreme heat wave. Schools were closed last week due to high temperatures. The Weather Bureau there warned the heat wave will continue for at least 3 more days. The United Nations Weather Agency has said Asia is warming at a particularly rapid pace due to climate change. Well, in southern China, a tornado struck the city of Guangzhou, killing 5 people and injuring 33 more. Around 140 factory buildings were also damaged, but no houses collapsed. Hailstones the size of golf balls also battered farmlands and residential areas in Guangdong. Over in the U.S., at least 4 people are dead, including an infant, following a tornado outbreak in Oklahoma. Dozens of twisters swept across the U.S. southern plains, with more than 7 million Americans under tornado warnings Sunday. Storm warnings were also issued for more than 47 million people from East Texas to Illinois and Wisconsin. The severe weather is expected to continue until Monday.